Now let's talk about the velocity of sound in adiabatic process. For adiabatic process, the pressure density relationship is given by this formula, where K is the adiabatic index. So it is very similar to what we did in the isothermal process case in the previous video. You will have this. Let's differentiate it. So you will have d of p into rho to the power minus k is equal to 0, and it will be p into minus k into rho to the power minus k minus 1 d rho plus rho to the power minus k dp is equal to 0. Let's divide the entire equation by rho to the power minus k. This would give you minus k into p into rho to the power minus 1 d rho plus dp. Okay, so very simple and almost similar to what we did in the previous video. From here you'll get dp by p is equal to k into d rho upon rho. Okay, so you'll have dp by d rho is equal to k into p upon rho. So p upon rho is, you know, r into t. So we'll write it down as k into r into t. Some books use it as gamma. The symbol of k is gamma. Don't get confused. It is the adiabatic index. So now if you remember the formula for the velocity of sound, it is under root dp by d rho, dp upon d rho. This will be equal to k into r into t, k into r into t. So this is the relation to calculate the velocity of sound for a compressible fluid undergoing an adiabatic process. Okay, so make a note of this. After this video, we'll go on to some numerical solving on these topics.